Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best in Slot, and we are back playing a little bit more Zoo Tycoon 2. Bear with me a second as we click the magical animal button. I want to thank you guys. A lot of you have given me some great suggestions. We already kind of had our plan for the next episode, but the main thing we're going to do right now is click this little button over here, and that's going to let us filter our animals. Loads of you guys recommended this, and it's a really good idea. Something I definitely should have checked and learned about before last episode. Now, before we go on, what was I going to do with my life? Let's not ask that question, actually. I've turned the sound up a little bit. Maybe this time you can hear the spooky music. Spooky, eh? Now, it turns out I did not have endangered animals installed. I actually told one of you in the comments that I definitely did. A few of you mentioned to me that I didn't have it installed because the icon wasn't there on the home screen. I was 100% sure I had it installed. It was just complete mistake on my part. You know, I really thought I had it installed. I thought I had every expansion sorted, but it turns out I didn't actually have it. So little problems like that shadow demon monkey boop, boop, boop thing we had in the last episode, that should no longer be a problem. So what we're going to do is we're going to try that out again. We're going to find that little spooky demon thing, and we're going to put it in the this exhibit. Ooh, vampire beast. Oh, hello. Oh, that's kind of cool. Look at that thing. Hello, beautiful. Well, spooky, but still. Right, so this might take a minute, but we're going to find ourselves our lovely spooky, spooky critter. Is that it? Oh, that's demonite. That's close, though. It's similar. Kind of... No, not a dinosaur. Oh, God, so many dinosaurs. Somebody came up with a really, really cool idea for an exhibit, which actually may be... I think we need to do a dinosaur exhibit next, because it's gonna trigger me if I don't get some dinosaurs in my game. But after that, somebody... And I've completely forgotten your name already. I apologize. Came up with the idea for like a movie-themed exhibit. So you could have like a King Kong-themed exhibit, like a single Jurassic Park-themed exhibit. You could have Godzilla. You could have a lot of fun with that. And I love that as an idea for a future episode. Where the hell is this little spooky thing? I know people are shouting at me right now to use the arrow, but I don't know what mod it's from, so that doesn't really help me that much. I have a horrible feeling I'm never going to find it. No, it's there, it's there. Right. So what we're going to do is we're going to put it down. And if it works, it works. If it doesn't, we'll just stick with the Jersey Devil thing. Because I'd like to find a more appropriate exhibit for the Jersey Devil. Is it going to work? It looks better. It's not standing up straight and weird. I think it might be. Yes, there we go. That's all I've ever wanted. Right, I'm sorry, Jersey Devil. You've been lovely. Maybe you'll come back some other day. But for now... Time for you to bugger off, Sonny Jim. How do I rotate? That's how I rotate. Everyone's really happy looking at my spooky shadow demons. I'm glad. I always get worried that my shadow demon just isn't good enough, you know? It's nice to get that affirmation that people out there do like my shadow demons. People love my shadow demons. Hello? I mean, you're basically just a terrifying looking little monkey. You're actually kind of happy and goofy looking. I love you. Hello. It's not really a spooky zoo, is it? I think we're going to rename it to the Cryptos. No, it's fine. Whatever. But it's kind of more crypto-focused than anything else. Because real animals, generally speaking, aren't that spooky. It's just the way it is. Oh, little Jersey Devil. Sorry, you're going to get murdered by a bloody shadow demon. I'm doing it for your own good. Anyways, we are now going to build another exhibit. And, well, first we're going to click that button. I really want to click this button. Boom. What's this? Okay, so somebody, I think the mod maker actually, came and told me which to click. So we just keep scrolling down. Duck pack! Yeah, we could have a duck-based zoo. That would be terrible. Your zoo has become more famous, yes, because of the shadow demons. Paranoia content. There's another one as well. Oh, look at this. All right, so all of these things here are, like, non-existent. Hogzilla. Let's have a little look, see what we've got. Oh my god, we've got tons. Whoever made this, I think you did comment. I love you and you're a brilliant human being. The Nandy Bear, the well-known Nandy Bear. The Vampire Bear, I really like that. I'm thinking like a nice little exhibit for that. The Thunderbird, a fabled beast that was meant to have a like record wingspan. There's like this old drawing of one from the 1800s or something. I don't really know that much about it, to be honest. Okay, some of these are real. Black cats, for example, are real. Chupacabra! We could do like a Mexico thing and have some sheep. That'd be awesome. What's this? Hodag. You're a Hodag. Who are you calling Hodag? Kirin. Anything big? Oh, they can call a Membe. Already talked about Loch Nessie. Mongolian Deathworm. was also on an episode of Thingamajiggy. Oh, the Jackalope. Yeah, was also on an episode of Destination Truth. I love Destination Truth. It's a terrible program. They never see anything vaguely worth seeing, but I absolutely adore it. And I recognize so many of these. God, what is that? I don't even know what that is, but I love it. Gambo, Leviathan, Warriken, Datsul Worm. Right, okay. So if you scroll down a little bit more. Okay. I don't know how I'm going to filter for Gothic. Which is kind... Oh, no, it wouldn't be in here. So if we go into... Sorry, folks. I just wanted to kind of try this out. If we go into Fences... Oh, and then it's... It's brilliant. Maybe we can use this low Gothic fence over here instead of the glass. Kind of really sell the theme a bit more, you know? Because now you'll be able to see in. I have installed another mod, the combi mod or whatever people suggested to me. That should mean we can stack trees really close together. That's going to be really good. And while we're here, what we need is some donation boxes. And I believe we do have spooky donation boxes, don't we? Man, I love this thing. I think that is meant to be blood, you know? But it's not. It's nice. What's this? Gothic fountain. Oh, it's so, so lovely. What's that? I don't know what literal it is. I'm sure I should know what that means, but I actually do not have a clue what literal means. I mean, I know what literal... I literally don't know what literal means. I'm a terrible person. There we go. Got some nice Gothic boxes. I think that's really cool, thematically. Okay. I mean, seems incredibly dangerous. Little children just cheering for their woo! It looks like they're running around going woo! I think the female looks different as well. And they are being groomed. They are very much monkeys, aren't they? Okay, right. Instead of blabbering on for the last 7 minutes, maybe we should put a bloody creature in the game. So what are we going to go for? I don't know where that little... I think the thing I was picking from last episode isn't part of the Paranoia Pack. And I'd rather just go for something I can find. So we're just going to pick something from this list. And we are going to... Let's build Mexico. I really like that. I think that's a really cool idea. We're going to build Mexico. Okay. So... I'm going to get the path to come out just like that to keep a bit of symmetry just in this early phase. But then we'll change things up later on. So let's just go... How much room have we got down here? Ah, frickin' tons! Frickin' tons! There we go. It doesn't need to be the exact same. Oh, it does. It's going to... Oh, I think it needs to be longer, doesn't it? It doesn't need to be exact, but it needs to be close. Just needs to be close. All I'm looking for. That looks close to me. Okay, there we go. It no longer looks like a penis. And if it does look like a penis, I advise you see your doctor. Right! So what we need is put some fences up first. We're going to stick with a graveyard for this section. Although, deadwood fence, that sounds like a good idea for Mexico, doesn't it? I'm not sure why, but it sounds like a good idea for Mexico. I don't want this to curve around in the same way. We might just... No, I do. Let's keep the symmetry for now. People love symmetry. Okay, I love symmetry. And I'm people, despite what my doctor told me. Let's go down there. Go a bit further, maybe. The fences feel weird this time around, must be said. I'm not really sure what that's about, but... How far did that fence go? Actually, probably not even this far. We'll stop it there. That's bloody plenty. Bloody plenty. Up and then nope. Okay, back a bit further up. Easy does it. Across. Yes, perfect. Because now we go up by one diagonal, and that should match. And it does. And it's 1 2. I don't care. it's 1 2 high. It's literally 1 2 high. Oh, that's making me sick. Oh, I'm gonna kill myself. Okay. Okay. Let's get the old this thing out and knock some of this down. That is a very nice little fence, though, isn't it? It's very Mexican. Does that mean anything? Is that insulting? It doesn't feel insulting, but I'm sure somebody will find a way to be insulted. People find a way to be insulted about absolutely bloody everything. I think it's okay. It looks good, though. It's a really nice fence. Well done, fence man. What I think we might do, though, is replace the outskirts with the higher stuff. I really like the idea of the exhibits being obviously not closed off, but restricted in terms of your visibility, you know? I think it creates a bit more natural drama in the exhibit design. And I want this to feel kind of like, honestly, in my head, it's kind of like Breaking Bad. And it's going to be just sort of a Mexican plane with a little hut we're going to build and that kind of jazz. I kind of want to flatten this. I want this one to be flat. Where's my flat button? Flatten! I quite like that as well. It's like the little cliff there. It just separates the exhibits from the rest of the zoo. Now we are going to go more advanced with future exhibits. We are actually running out of room. I'm going to have to go a little bit smaller. Or maybe I'll just make large exhibits in the future. It seems a bit silly in retrospect to go for medium, doesn't it? I feel slightly silly about that. Oh well. Can I flatten over the water? No, we have to biomodify that, don't we? We'll do that later. We can fit like 5 more in here though. We don't want to go crazy on all the zoos because the point is to try lots of different ones. Okay, so. What type of thing? Where's my chupacabra? El chupacabra. The goat sucker. Semi-desert. Click that button there. And this gives us all our stuff. So, semi-desert, that's what we needed. I think we're really going to just emphasize the dirt. Don't know why my game world is so dark. But that's kind of what I wanted, I suppose. We wanted dark and spooky, and we got dark and spooky. And El Chupacabra strikes at night. El Chupacabra. Okay. Maybe a little grass and dirt in some places. Actually, we'll have that down here, right? And that's where they. This is where the house is going to be. And then, down here, we'll put a little river, streamy area. And this is where they leave the goats at night, so they can drink and eat a little bit of grass. Just a little bit of grass around the river for the goats. And it makes sense, doesn't it? For the grass to be near the river, so. And that is where El Chupacabra will strike. Okay, cool. Right, trees. Let's get some nice dead trees in here. Does that work? Yeah, look at that. Beautiful. I mean, okay, I obviously didn't want it like that, but still. I need to remember how to auto-rotate. Is it going to tell me? Oh, I do remember. Little dead bit over there. Just a couple of these knocking around. And we need some nice trees, but not many. I really want to emphasize the spookiness. Which I'm sure you're all pretty used to by now. These ones would be nearer the nearer by the river where there's a higher water supply. And these ones not quite so lucky. Maybe just one over here. Okay, let's get some rocks. I think I forgot rocks last time. That's very upsetting. Did download quite a few rocks as well. We've got, honestly, guys, we've got so much stuff. So many mods. People have warned me that there's a limit on how many mods you're allowed in the game. Something like 500, I think somebody said. I know my game started to break at about 300 last time, so I guess we'll see what happens, really. I want to push it as much as we can. There's a lot to love about the game, but it gets a whole lot better with mods. Okay, right. No more. Goodbye, Hollow Log. You had your chance. You've ruined it. Let's get some cacti. This is making me want to watch Breaking Bad again. I've not seen Breaking Bad in years. They don't need to be by the water, but we'll have these little bushes closer to the river. Some ivy poison. That's quite cool looking. Just little patches every now and again. Create the theme. Create a real... I really want my exhibits to feel not like exhibits, but like slices of the real world. You know, that's really where my emphasis is and pretty much always has been. Now, the cool thing about the shelter in this one is we can pretend the shelter is actually for the sheep. So by the river, we could... If we rotate that, maybe... I'm going to get rid of that tree. We'll just move it there. We have the shelter there. Let's put a... let's put a nice big rock next to it as well. Bring that up a little bit. I wish all the rocks didn't have nipples, I've got to say. I don't know why all the rocks have nipples, but pretty much all the rocks have nipples. There we go, that's pretty cool. And let's get another tree as well. Put that aside. I just want it to feel a little nestled away. Maybe to hide the sheep from El Chupacabra. Okay, so the shelter will work for the Chupacabra, but the idea is it's not actually for the Chupacabra. Or maybe I just put cows in. Oh no, it should be a goat really, shouldn't it? I can put a bone in. Bone is subtle. I don't really see the bone. And some little lizards running around. That's very Mexican, I guess. Oh, it's actually a goat! Oh, that is perfect! Oh, I'm so happy with life right now. Okay. We'll have to keep resupplying the goats, but... Two goats. Right there. Bam. And we'll have a few more goats. It's a little herd of goats that the farmer keeps, and then... The Chupacabra can actually eat that. That is amazing. Oh, I'm so happy about that. Right. Food. Will he actually eat? It does say live food, so I assume it will eat it. Terrain blood. Oh my god, this just keeps getting better. Although, it is floating. How do I make things lower? Like, raise and... I'm sure there's a way, but I don't know how to do it. We'll have to figure that out some other time. Right, got my goats. So what I want to do now, before we put the actual Chupacabra in... is build like a little house. I want this to feel like somebody could realistically actually live here. You know, I want it to be a little building. And this is doable. Whether it's something I can personally do is a whole other kettle of fish. But I'm going to try. Okay, I don't want to be on paranoia anymore. Cryptozoology, educational podium. Man, I love cryptozoology so much. I really want to do a series on it called Monster or Myth. Which I think is a great name. But I know Thingy. What's his name? Oh, I've forgotten his name. I feel so mean. The guy does some really good dinosaur videos. Very educational stuff. I've completely forgotten his name and I'm super sorry about that. But he does a lot of cryptozoology stuff. But it's still something I'd really like to do. Well, that's not working at all, is it? Okay, they don't work. So remember that for future reference. Okay, so we're just going to... Okay, none of these are working. That is working, but it's float. Why is everything floating? Stop floating! How do I make it not float? I don't want it to float. Also, I took grid off. I don't know why it's still... Guys, I give up. I'm a failure at life. I can't figure it out. This is the one problem I'm always going to have with this playthrough. Is that I'm... Is that meant to be a... Interesting. I think that's actually meant to be a roof. Let's try that. Elevated path is definitely how I think you're meant to do roofs in this game. It's a very good way of doing it. I'm sorry, who? Who? There you go. Goodbye. I've been adopted by... Well, at least it's not into the wild, you know? Releasing a Jersey Devil into the wild actually sounds like a fairly terrible idea. We released multiple stagnated, stationary... Spooky demon orders last episode, and that's a terrible idea as well. Okay! What one do we like? Let's just go for that one. Has that worked? I'm a genius! Okay, whoever made the mod is a genius, actually. But still, look at that! Yeah! I mean, it's not great, but it's a thing. Maybe I should get rid of one of the panels. And then, if we can find a different door, maybe it'll look a little bit more like a building than it does right now. Because right now it doesn't look like a building. I'm pretty sure there's something we can do about... Well, this would have been helpful. Okay, so when I'm in path, I can actually... No, I can only put it on something. Interesting. Okay, scenery. Scenery? Scenery. Scenery? Scenery. Scenery! Scenery. We're looking for the panels again. It wasn't his scenery, was it? Maybe he has a little jeep. Would he have a little jeep? He wouldn't have a dinosaur jeep anyway. Where's the other jeeps? There's many jeeps. Many jeeps. Okay. They're all a bit... No, he wouldn't have a jeep, would he? Stupid Besson's lot. It was in this bit. Was it in this bit? Maybe I could have used the big fences. Oh, God only knows. One day we'll figure all this out. Won't be today, but one day. Okay, we're looking for a door panel. That's a different... No. I know there's more down this end, so... Alright, why are you... There we go. Yeah. Yeah. It's brilliant. I know you're all sitting there thinking, wow, Bethesda, like, that is the greatest thing I've ever seen. I know it is. I know it is. Okay, we need to pick... No. No. Wearing overalls, right? He's working on the farm, looking after the, what are they called? Goats! Goats is what they're called. That's our dude. That's our little Mexican dude. He's only Mexican because Chupacabra lives in Mexico, right? Okay, where's my goats? I had many goats, and now I have zero goats. Is that a goat? The exhibit is massive, and it's kind of hard to... That's a bone. Where are my goats? What the hell? Goats. My goats have disappeared. It's Christmas, 1992 all over again. This is very obsessing for me. I will not accept that. Okay, right. Chupacabra time. Scroll down. Oh, it's already there. Sweet. I think I only want one. I think thematically, there would only be one Chupacabra. El Chupacabra. Okay, let's go. Actually, we should see this from the outside first. Make sure it actually works as an exhibit. What do you do? Just a lovely little day. Hey, what's this dangerous looking path down here? Let's go this way. Yeah. Oh, look at that. It looks like a Mexican goat farm. And I know what they look like. But I am an expert in Mexican goat farming. Oh, lizards. Hello. Well, you didn't disappear. My goats may have disappeared, but you're fine. Is he going to eat a goat? You're very small. And you kind of just look like a dog. You're going to eat a goat? Be a baller, son. Shadow Demon 4, I don't want to see... We're going to get little baby Shadow Demons! Oh, that's going to be kind of... Eat some... Look, delicious! You are the most gormless looking Chupacabra. We're going to make the other exhibit smaller. It needed that feel of a big open goat farm. I don't know what my addiction with the goat farm is, but it's there. Okay, I really like this. The actual exhibit's really nice looking. One day, he'll get up and murder something. One day, I've got faith. I don't have faith, you're bloody useless, aren't you? What's your idea? Is it to kill something? Who's a good Chupacabra? Who's a good Chupacabra? Look, I need to do a thumbnail, right, for this video. Right now, you are giving me nothing, son. I am going to have to Google Chupacabra and put a funny photo of a Chupacabra as a thumbnail at this rate. Because you are useless. Look at the delicious one. I'm going to show you how to eat a goat, okay? This dude. Oh, look at the food. You can even this dude. This dude doesn't care. Look at him. He's got nothing to live for. Kill him. I feel like there was more goats. I feel like there are a lot of goats. Look how easy this is. You're the J-Pog goat. I think you're the J-Pog goat. You are terrifying. You have no eyes. The eyes are most the delicious part of the goat. It's moving! It's on the hunt. Wait, no. Wrong music. Dum 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 dum. If you go into that shelter, there is gonna be trouble, Buster. You hear me? There's gonna be trouble. This is. Okay. Right, we're going to end it there. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you have enjoyed the building of our Mexican goat exhibit. Because I don't believe there's a Chupacabra in it. Oh, no. Alternate plan. Give me a minute. Okay. We need to go back into paranoia. Alternate plan. Where is the Mongolian death worm? It's not quite the right biome. Hot desert. But I think it'll do. Bam. Yeah. Look at that thing. Spooky as balls. Okay, stop being bubbly. Thank you. Do you move? Do you do anything? What do you do? So it kind of sit on the ground. Which is cool that it's actually halfway on the ground. I like that. It's on the move. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Not the right music, but I just thought. Look at it go. Oh, that's cool. You're much better than the Chupacabra. Look at the goat. Look at it. Look at it go. Oh. I don't care that you're happy. You're a Mongolian death worm. No, you're not lifting. It's not leg day. It's goat day. God damn it, death worm. Look, look, look. Go, go, go. Nom, 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 nom. Give up. I'm angry at the world. How are you not hungry? Oh, you are hungry. So I have to stick with this. I have faith. I have so much faith that this one of these two is going to murder a goat. They don't have another food source, right? I haven't, except the lizard, maybe. Even just murder a lizard. I'd be okay with you murdering a lizard. You murder, just murder something. That's all I'm asking for. A little bit of murder. Does it not want the live enrichment food? Shall we just give it some... Okay, I'm going to give it some blood, okay? That'll do. That's an image. You know, it's Chupacabra, it's feasting on blood. Yeah. I don't know what it is, but it really was not going for the live food. Which is mildly upsetting, I think you'll all agree. There you go. Great. Even the blood is following me. And you, Mr. Mongolian Deathworm, you are just as bad. Useless. Useless. Okay, we're going to end it there. Thank you for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. I shall see you lovely folks in the next episode. Cheers. Oh, no, 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 no. Before we go. What do we do next episode? We've got all these cool creatures. You see most of them. Shut up, world. That is baller. You've seen most of them already. That's a unicorn right there. Unicorns aren't spooky. I really want a Kraken exhibit. That's going to be really cool. We could do like a big old water one. That's cute. What's the one I wanted to use though? Oh yeah, the vampire beast. Look at it! I don't know. It's up to you guys as well. What do you want to see? Giant anaconda. We could do like a river. We could make... We're going to save the giant anaconda, right? Because we're going to do a movie exhibit. Maybe next. Or maybe just after a dinosaur one. Movie zoo. And we could remake Anaconda as well. Which is a pretty cool idea. So, it's up to you guys. What do you want to see out of this little list here? Anything in particular you would like to see added in the next episode? Look at that thing. So much good stuff. Okay, thank you, Jeremy. Cheers. Much love. And as always, bye-bye.